In this video, we'll discuss what's going to happen to the MCC after Halo Infinite's release, the frequency that we'll probably expect to see for Halo Infinite updates, the glory days of Halo, as well as how will these semi-open world of the campaign play into the multiplayer. We'll stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving another commentary. Today we're doing a little bit of a Q&A kind of video, answering some of your burning questions from the community. I posted up on my community page here on my channel, so if you guys want to check out those posts, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And I asked you, what kind of questions do you have for Halo Infinite, or just Halo in general? And I got an amazing response from you guys. I had over 90 comments on this, so this is why we're breaking up into multiple videos, and so I really appreciate your guys' support. If you like these kind of videos, make sure to tap that like button. Let me know when you see some more content like this. If you want to take part of the next video, guys, make sure you subscribe to catch it when those posts do go live. So without further ado, let's just jump right into this. Yusef Sofyan, I thought we pronounced it correctly, says, what do you think will happen to the MCC after the release of Halo Infinite? Past Season 5, do you think there will be continued support? The current plan right now for the MCC that we know from 343 says that they're going to be releasing new seasons for the MCC every 2 months in 2021. Starting in January with Season 5. And continuing on that pattern up until Season 10 is what they kind of have the idea of what they're going to be doing for the MCC, which takes us right to November of 2021 when Halo Infinite releases. And 343 did state that at that time, they're going to try to assess the situation and see what's going to be going on with the MCC, what's going to be going on with Halo Infinite and things like that to try to figure out where exactly to go with this game. The MCC does have tons of new features coming in 2021 before the release of Halo Infinite, so we definitely will be talking about that on this channel for sure. What's going to happen to the MCC after Halo Infinite's release? Well, I couldn't imagine a whole lot of people wanting to play MCC with the new game coming out, because we've really been hungry for a new Halo experience. And though the Halo MCC community is there, dedicated and strong, it is a rather small community with population peaks, you know, up in the double digit thousands, like kind of like 13 to 15,000 people on the Steam charts alone. So probably maybe bump that up to me about 20-25,000 if you can take in consideration the Xbox and PC communities. Though with no new games coming out in 2021 and just some features here and there, some new content drops, maybe some new maps and stuff like that being released in, I can see the population dwindling down over time in 2021 because, you know, people are just going to lose interest. We saw this happen throughout 2020 with the releases of new Halo games, that they would have a big spike of population when the new game comes out, kind of settles back down, has a new spike, kind of settle back down. But this one, I think we're just kind of to see like a gradual decline with MCC, probably, you know, towards November, getting really low in population, where I don't think it'd be very viable to release new like content for seasons and things like that. I see the big thing that's going to carry MCC beyond Halo Infinite, which I did make a video on this, is going to be the modding community. Mods will be keeping this game live and strong. People are going to be making a lot of content. There's so much stuff you can play around with modding within the MCC, that I feel like the community there could just keep creating new stuff that would even take people away from Halo Infinite. Check out new stuff in the MCC for the modding community. So I think that's going to be the main emphasis. And 343 knows this as they're reaching out to the modding community, asking them, what do you want to see? What kind of mod support do you want to have? They're talking about adding in mod tools, which will create content way faster for the modding community as well. You know, MCC has been out there since 2014, and I think a lot of people are going to be jumping over to Halo Infinite, even if it's like a mediocre game, not even that well liked. I think a lot of people are going to be playing Halo Infinite just because it's new Halo content. So, long-winded answer condensed down to a sentence. Season's probably ending. Modding content's gonna be the way to go for MCC after Halo Infinite's release. Marcelino, if I pronounce it correctly, asks, what Halo game did I have the most fun playing? I would think it would have to be a pretty close tie between Combat Evolved and Halo 3 for my games I had the most fun playing. The reason why I had so much fun playing Combat Evolved is because during that time, there was no online play, so people would get together in basements, link up systems, link up TVs and play together. That was one of my most cherished moments ever in my gaming lifetime. Now, honestly, I've always kind of felt like I've been chasing that experience of trying to have that community link up, but just feeling like I have people around me who have the same interests as me and have enjoyed the same types of things I have fun with. That was Combat Evolved for me. And that's every weekend we'd come over to my house, system link, and just play countless hours. We even invite kids we didn't like over to our house just to even out the teams because we needed an eighth. Though with the invention of online play during the Xbox days, Halo 3 would probably be the next one just because I think that's when the community peaked. I met so many great people throughout playing Halo 3 online, just, you know, creating so much Forge content. The YouTube community was kind of, you know, just budding right there at the moment. And it's just that time was also probably the best online experience I ever had playing Halo, where the best gaming experience in person I ever had was definitely was Combat Evolved. I'm hoping with Halo Infinite, you get a little bit of both. Yep, the Destroyer asks, do you think I will be in the game, referring to Halo Infinite? And from what I've seen you do with Halo 2, I look forward to it, but I'm also highly concerned. Mr. All-Star HD asks, how often do you think updates will be pushed out? Assuming they go through with their 10-year plan, they would surely have to produce content often to ensure a good and positive player count. And that is very true. It pretty much would almost have to be nearly monthly at the beginning of the game, and maybe just towards like the middle part of the year, probably focus on maybe every season. We do expect to see season content coming out for Halo Infinite. In the recent development update, they did confirm that they're going to be having seasons with Halo Infinite. So I'm probably sure every 3, maybe 4 months, something like that, probably every 4 months, we see a big content drop, probably some new maps, new customization options, maybe new armor sets and things like that. And so I can imagine that rhythm. And in case if anything's broken or something gets overpowered, something like that, maybe a hot fix here and there. Halo Infinite's really been designed from the ground up to be able to produce content more efficiently and be able to update the game faster, because the way the market is now for shooters is that you need to be on top of what your community wants, like almost within the month of what's going on, unless it's gonna kill the game almost. And 343 recognizes that. That's why they spend so much time building out the Slipspace engine. But I have a feeling like every year we might get a big update, kind of maybe like some new missions or something like that for the campaign side of things, or maybe a new area to play around with. Though I would kind of expect maybe that be held more to a 2-year pattern. So every 2 years, you maybe get like a big campaign drop where got a whole new section of the ring to play in, or maybe it's a completely new spin-off game being released every 2 years or something like that. That's just the big thing what that Halo Infinite's looking to push is content and being served as a platform for people to go to when they want to play Halo. You play Halo Infinite. SG Alpha asks, is there any chance Halo returns to its glory days, or is the game past its prime? I certainly don't feel like the game is past its prime. It certainly peaked during the Xbox 360 days of Halo 3 especially, and ever since then I feel like that the game's been trying to mess around with the formula to try to update the game, to try to keep up with trends and things like that. And I think they kind of lost their way a little bit of what makes Halo so great and unique that makes people want to play it. There's certainly a need and a want for a new Halo experience. We've seen so many times that Halo Infinite is up there, usually nominated, if not always up there, for the most anticipated games that are going to be coming out. People are craving for a new Halo experience. They just haven't gotten a really, truly to spirit Halo experience really since Halo Reach, and even maybe we'll go even more true to the natural experience, probably Halo 3. Well, there certainly is an audience there for people to jump in and wanting to play Halo. Where I think that will it be the king of all shooters? Probably not. I think it would take time for that kind of stuff to happen. You know, even after like a year or two after the release of Halo Infinite, we might see that actually grow. Halo's kind of coming from an underdog point of view when it comes to the gaming community, because you have a lot of big heavy hitter shooters out there that Halo needs to compete with if it wants to be up there when the, you know, most notable games in the shooter genre. And what they're doing with Halo Infinite looks like they're going to try to capture that feeling. And I think that 343 can do that. It's a very delicate line that they have to balance on to try to do that properly, but I think it is very possible to bring it back. Are we going to see Halo 3 1 million population day one kind of stuff? I don't think so. I don't think any game is actually going to be able to capture that kind of stuff again, just because the market was so less saturated with really good games back then. Nowadays, every game out there is being built as a platform to try to be your game that you're going to put the most time in. Everyone's trying to fight for your time rather than your money, which was previously your money was the number one target, but now they're really trying to target in on your time playing the game, focusing on the content in there to try to get people to in that ecosystem, which, because once you get them hooked, then they'd be willing to spend money. It's a very difficult process to do. And I think Halo has been kind of under the radar for a long enough time to where it can have a resurgence and have like a rebirth, if you will. Think of like Aerosmith, if you guys ever heard of that band, you know, back in the 70s, they're really popular. And died out in the early 80s. Then like probably the late 80s, early 90s, they came back up, got popular, dropped out of popularity. And then back in the early 2000s, they got back up in popularity again. I'm expecting Halo Infinite to have an Aerosmith effect. Connor Vode, if that's how you pronounce it correctly, I got a lot of unique names in this one, asks, how will multiplayer tie into the rest of the game being open world and all? We did cover on this channel previously that Halo Infinite isn't exactly going to be open world. It's going to be very similar to, say, ODST, where you start out small, and as you progress through the story, it opens up where you can allow backtracking, but you won't be able to go everywhere at once. True open world like GTA and Cyberpunk, or just as soon as you're able to go out into the world, you can go wherever and whenever you want to do it. Halo Infinite's not exactly going to be like that. And 343 has been very specific on their wording when it comes to that. They said open and expansive world. They've never said open world together for that exact reason. So this is very important to think about, since Halo Infinite's gameplay for campaign is going to be very open-ended. That's going to be more of a world you can just go around and explore, rather than being set on different levels that you have to progress through like you did in previous more traditional Halo campaigns. So I would think that 343 would need to reutilize that content that they spent so much time building out that world, that they would have to reutilize that in the campaign. We've seen this kind of stuff happen, say with Warzone when it comes to Call of Duty, where the map of Verdansk, they have different areas within the map that you can go to, but also in the ground war modes, they actually just kind of section off areas of Verdansk and make that into a ground war map. So you can possibly see similar situations where BTB maps are actually just gonna be, you know, cut sections of the Halo Infinite campaign world. I think that would be actually a really smart way to reutilize content there. I mean, there's also been that rumor that everyone's talking about, if Battle Royale is gonna happen, if you're gonna have such a huge world for Halo Infinite, sounds like it would work really well for a Battle Royale mode, and all you need to do is just create spawns, and that's all you really would need to do. That's another way where they can reuse campaign content in the multiplayer. Though, of course, it could just also work for 4v4 modes as well. Maybe, you know, there are, obviously we do know there are going to be some dedicated apps to the multiplayer. We saw that in the recent development update. Though I wouldn't put it past 343 to reuse content from the campaign and throw it in the multiplayer. I mean, Bungie did that for Halo Reach all the time. Pretty much all of Halo Reach maps were just reused content from the campaign. So it certainly wouldn't be the first time we've seen reused content from the campaign in multiplayer, and I totally would expect to see something happen like that as well. Maybe more in the large scale game modes, we probably see it. Maybe for the more 4v4 stuff, have a more tailored experience that lends itself to something a little bit more specific to that game mode. Those are all the questions I have for you guys today. If you have any questions yourself, leave them in the comment section down below. I do read all of them and try to reply to most of them as well. If you're new to the channel or missing any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here to link to all my news and informational videos. You've been on the loop for the last few days or so. Thank you so much for watching. Really appreciate it. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.